Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you are all doing good. Children, we have completed our syllabus, our science syllabus from 7th textbook, isn't it, children? So we have completed all the lessons from lesson number 1 to lesson number 6. Today, I am going to do the revision because it is the time for the revision, children. So I will do the revision of all the lesson number 1 to lesson number 6. From lesson number 1 to lesson number 6, I am going to do the revision, children. Okay. Today, I am going to do the revision of lesson number 1. We will start with the lesson number 1, children. We will start the revision with lesson number 1. First, that is lesson number 1. We need A. This is the revision class, children. I am going to do the revision of lesson number 1. We need A. Okay, shall we start? Okay, children. So, in this lesson, we need A. We have learned many things. What we have learned, children? You have learned some new words. You have learned some new words. And you have learned about wind. What are the uses of the wind? And about fresh air. And about air occupies a space. Air has weight. And all the living things need air for breathing. Isn't it, children? Air is very necessary for living things. And these are all topics we have studied in lesson number 1. From the lesson number 1, we have studied these things. Isn't it, children? So, today I am going to do the revision one by one, children. What we have learned in lesson number 1, we need A. Okay? So, first one, we have learned new words. Isn't it, children? We have learned some new words. What are the new words, children? What we have learned the new words? First one, breeze. B-R-E-E-Z-E, breeze. Strobe, S-T-O-R-M, strobe. Second, third one, mixture. M-I-X-T-U-R-E, mixture. Fourth one, purify. P-U-R-I-F-Y, purify. Fifth one, active. A-C-T-I-V-E, active. And sixth one, drying. D-R-Y-I-N-G, dry ink. And seventh one, carry. C-A-R-R-I-E-D, carry. And eighth one, windmill. W-I-N-D, wind. M-I-L-L, windmill. Then the ninth one, breathe. B-R-E-A-T-H, breathe. And the last one, we have learned the last new word, 10th word, space. S-P-A-C-E, space. So these are all the 10 new words we have learned from lesson number 1. We need A. Next, isn't it, children? Okay, next move to the topic, that is wind. Next move to the topic, children, that is wind. What is meant by wind, children? What is meant by wind? Moving air is called wind. Moving air is called wind. And we have learned that air, we can't see the air, but air is all around us. It occupies all around us, correct? So, what is meant by wind? Moving air is called wind. So, what are the uses of the wind, children? What are the uses of the wind? We have already learned about the uses of the wind also, isn't it? So, first uses, that is helping windmill move. Wind helps to move the windmill and helps to moving the sailboat. And wind helps to dry the clouds and wind helps to fly the kites. And also, wind helps to carry very light seeds of plant to new places. And also wind helps to carrying very light seeds of plants to new places. So these are the uses of the wind. These are the uses of the wind. Correct, children? Isn't it? We have already learned in the class. So next, what we have learned, children? Slow moving air have also learned that slow moving air is called breeze and strong wind become strong. The strong wind become strong children. Correct? Isn't it children? So next what we have learned, that is fresh air. We have learned about the fresh air. So air is a mixture of gases. Air is a mixture of gases. That means air contains many mixed gases children, like carbon dioxide, oxygen, and even the carbon monoxide and all some gases it contains. Air contains some gases. So air is a mixture of gas. Correct children? So people like to eat fresh food. Food items that are not fresh, if you eat unhealthy food, you will become sick. Isn't it children? Like that only if you breathe unhealthy air, and you may get sick. Correct children? So breathing air must be pure. It must be pure. So breathing fresh air makes us healthy and active children. Breathing fresh air, it makes healthy and active us. Correct? When we breathe air that is not fresh, we feel tired and unwell. When we breathe air, if the breathing air is not healthy or if the breathing air is not fresh, we feel unwell or we will become sick. Isn't it children? So air also carries germs. Air also carries germs children. So when we cough or sneeze, our body throws out many germs which are mixed with air we breathe in. When we cough or when we sneeze, our body throws out some germs, isn't it children? That germs will mix up with the air and the air will get contaminated. Correct children? So breathing fresh air is very important to living things. Okay. Next, what we have learned, children, air occupies spaces. Air occupies space. How you can recognize air occupies some space? For this, the good example is balloon children. Isn't it? If you blow some air into balloon, what happens children? The balloon become big size like this. Correct? The balloon become big size like this. So it shows that air occupies the space inside the balloon. So that we can say that air occupies some space. Before blowing the balloon, how the balloon looks like children? Like this flattened balloon, right? Before blowing the air into the balloon, the balloon will seem like flattened, isn't it? We will see the balloon like flattened shape. But after blowing some air into the balloon become bigger in size. So it means that some air occupies the balloon and make the balloon size big. Correct? So it shows this activity shows that children, what this activity will show us, that activity shows that air occupies some space. Correct children? Then if you remove the air from the balloon, again the balloon will become flattened. Correct? Again the balloon will become flattened. So this shows that air occupies some space. Isn't it children? Next one, what we have learned children? It is air has weight. In this same manner only we learned that air has weight. Correct children? If you take example for the football, if you take an example football children, what will happen if the blowing football or the the field with this football, if it is filled with the air, if you blow with the air, it is become very big size and it is very heavy also. Isn't it children? If for the weight of this football only we can kick the football itself, isn't it, children? If you remove the air from the football, what will happen? It will become flattened, right? We can't kick the football. We can't play the football also. So this shows that this activity shows that air has weight. Air has weight, children. Okay. So next, what we have learned? Air is needed for breathing. Air is very necessary for the breathing purpose. Air is very necessary for the breathing purpose. We need air to breathe. Plants and animals breathe in air, and even fish also breathe the air which is present in the fresh water, children. The fresh water always contains the oxygen amount, some oxygen amount. The fresh water will always contain some amount of oxygen. So with the help of this oxygen, fish will breathe in air which is present in the water, isn't it, children? So these are all the things what we have learnt in lesson number 1. We need air. We have already learnt in the class itself, children. So I did the revision itself. So children, read the lesson number 1. We need air from sent to textbook, so that if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the interaction class, children. Okay, we will discuss in the interaction class. So let's clarify the doubts about the lesson number 1. We need air. Okay, in the next class we will do the TB exercises of the we will do the revision of the TB exercises of lesson number 1. So read well lesson number 1, children. Okay, so in the next class we will continue with the TB exercises of this lesson, that is lesson number 1. We need air. Okay, thank you.